Hello, this is Anastasia at Whalesware. In this video, we will learn all ins and outs of filter formula. Watch it till the end to get another 5 useful tips and tricks and boost your skills in Google Sheets. In our last video, we have learned the basics of using filter in Google Sheets. If you want to rewatch it, please use the card above. Now let's discover how to pick specific columns and order them in any way you want, how to make operations on the filtered subsets, and how to get rid of irritating NAs. Consider subscribing to Whalesware channel. If you like this video, press thumbs up. Today we will start from using OR logic in filter. We tap equal filter, open parenthesis, and select the columns we want to filter, payments A2 to C. Then select region column as criteria equal to EMEA. Now it shows clients and their subscription type for EMEA. To use the OR operator in the formula, we add plus and one more criteria, region equal to Africa. Wrap both criteria in parentheses and press enter. You see that the list has expanded and now shows clients with their subscription types for both EMEA and Africa. Apply unique to get rid of duplicates. Wrap the formula into braces and add headers A1 to C1 from payments. Add semicolon to place headers and the outcomes vertically. And don't forget to use the indentation. Now let's use the AND operator in filter. In a simple filter formula, comma acts as an AND operator. So if we want to see clients from EMEA or Africa and premium subscriptions only, we wrap the region's criteria into parentheses, comma, and add a new condition, subscription type to be equal to premium. And this one should be also wrapped in parentheses. Asterisk works as an AND operator as well, so you can use either comma or asterisk. Use the color coding. Mark cells containing formulas with a darker color and cells containing formula results with lighter color. Add color separators to mark where the outcomes of one formula end. Watch our video about the spreadsheet formatting. The card should appear right above. If you are still wondering how do I add a set of headers or how do I place the headers and outcomes vertically after one another, watch our video about working with arrays in Google Sheets. There you will learn how to pull different sets of data and order them in any way you prefer. When using filter, you might want to pull two or more columns that do not stand together and place them in a specific order. I want to see the EMEA clients' names, payments done by them, and the transaction date, as well as the region displayed. But I don't need other information from the data source. We create an array first. Use braces and add columns to be displayed separated by comma. We open the braces, select names, region, payment amounts, and the transaction date. Close braces and hit enter. You can change the order of columns in the array, and Google Sheets will adapt the output accordingly. Let's change places for transaction dates and payment amounts. Change it in the set and the columns will move as well. Now let's apply filter to this range. Don't forget about the formula formatting. Not to hard code the values, I've added the values to refer to on the top. Wrap the range in parentheses and add filter in the beginning. Now we want the region from payments to be EMEA, so equal to F1. Voila, here is the filtered set we want. Add headers to make the subset readable. Wrap the whole formula into braces. Add new braces before filter to pull a set of headers. Select the headers from payments, separated by comma. And remember that the headers order should match the columns order. So we pull the name, region, transaction date, and payment amounts. close the braces, put a semicolon, and hit enter. Add color coding and a separator. Use this approach to filter any columns you want in any order you want. Now let's add one more criteria to filter. The transaction date should be before November 1st, 2018. I have this date in a separate cell here. Before we move on with filtering, make sure the transaction date format is an actual date. Here is a trick how to do it. First, select the cells you need to check. Then go to Format, Number, choose Date as a format. If it's an actual date, it will be aligned on the right in the cell, and if you change the date format, it will also change. Moreover, if you change the format from date to number, it will become a number. However, if you input a value that is not a date, it will not change and will be aligned on the left. You can edit those to make them dates. Now let's add the date criteria to the formula. We select the transaction date column in Payments, and it should be less than the date in F2. And here are the payments from clients in EMEA done before November 1st, 2018.
It is cool to pull the filtered subsets, but what's next? You can easily combine filter with many other formulas. Use filter inside of sum, average, count, etc.
Let's get total, average amount, and count of the number of payments from EMEA clients. The transaction date should be equal or after November 1st, 2018. We filter payment amounts, select EMEA as the region, and transaction date to be exactly or after November 1st, 2018. Now we will copy this formula to use for different operations. For the function to contain correct values, I lock the values I want to keep by using F4 for PC or function plus F4 for Mac. We can wrap filter inside sum. And here is the total of payments. We can wrap filter inside average. And here is the average transaction amount. We can count the number of filtered transactions. So we see that we had 5 payments in total.
However, filter doesn't work with all of the formulas. For example, you cannot nest filter inside of array formula, so you might need to copy it.
If the order of columns in the original data source might be changed, use filter inside filter to dynamically refer to a column name. This approach works well for the data pulled from another spreadsheet. First, identify what data you want to see. Let's have a look at the names of our clients, their subscription types, and regions. We copy-paste the titles from payments. These values are static and are used to keep the sense of the sheet. Now let's filter the subset. And here is another trick on how to pull data without headers. Let's put all of the data we want from the Payments tab. I filter payments from A to C. As a criteria, I state that the row of A to A should be greater than the row of payments A1. If I know that the header is in line number 1, I will filter out the values only. Now I want to make sure that I pull the correct data for this column even if its position in the original data source changes. So, from the filtered subset I already have, I want to filter the data the header of which matches the static header I have here. So I wrap the filter inside another filter and add a condition. Payments A1 to C1 to be equal to M1. To copy this to other two columns I have here, I first log the values that should not change using F4. In fact, the only value that should not change here is the static header we refer to. Now I simply drag the function to the neighboring cells and it will be copied automatically matching the correct static header. If we change the headers, for example to client names, the output will be an NA or an error. To spot the errors and navigate users' actions in the correct direction, I use IFERROR formula. If the error is spotted, I can give a hint on what went wrong. Let's wrap our formula into parentheses and add if error in the beginning. When you hit enter, you see that NA has disappeared. Now, let's create a hint. After the filter function, add a message you want to be displayed when the error occurs. In our case, the error could be caused by one column name, so I will add comma and write a message in quotes, wrong column name. If you change back to the correct column name, it will show the results. Apply if error to all of the formulas we have in this set. The last trick I will present today is using len function to limit your arrays. Len returns the length of the string. Filter output is an array itself. To show only the results that contain values, you can add len as a criteria in filter. So let's filter the payments from EMEA that are not empty. I type equality sign, braces, add a header which is G1 from the payments tab, semicolon. Now we type filter, set to be filtered, payments G2 to G, first criteria, region to be EMEA, and the length of G2 to G to be greater than 0. Now let's say we provide 10% discount for our clients. Let's count the discount amounts for each payment done. I will use an array formula here. Press the bell to get notified on our upcoming video about this one. In brief, array formula expands the function to the entire column. It will perform multiple calculations on one or more sets of values. If I want to make an operation on each cell in the column, which contains different values, I can use array formula not to copy it for each row. Coming back to our discount calculations. I type equality sign, braces, and a header discount amount, semicolon, array formula, open parenthesis. Select a range Q2 to Q from the current sheet and multiply it by 10% or 0.1. Close parenthesis, close braces, and hit enter. We see a lot of zeros here. A bit irritating, right? So let's get rid of those. I will use the next combination of functions inside the array formula. If len of Q2 to Q is equal to 0, then the result should be empty for true. And calculate Q2 to Q multiplied by 10% if false. Close parenthesis, braces, hit enter, and the zeros fade away. Mark cells with outcomes and formulas, and add a separator. You can use this approach with many other formulas that create arrays.
I hope now you can filter anything you want in any order you want. Press like if you've learned something new today. You can always advance your approaches by subscribing to Railsware channel. Here we share the best tips and tricks we use every day. Press the bell not to miss any of our tutorials. Thank you and see you next time!